Let's have a little chat in the early morning, a little occult chat. I'm going to keep my voice down because I don't want to wake others up. So I hope you guys can hear me. But I wanted to come through because when I wake up in the morning and I wake up full of passion, which I do a lot of times, there were words coming out of my mouth, and I know that that's spirit. And these words that were coming out of my mouth, and these thoughts that were in my mind, were saying to me, why do we sell ourselves short? And when I say that, I'm talking to people in general. Why do we sell ourselves short? Why do we allow other people to put limits on what we can accomplish? Why do we allow other people to put limits on what we can do from our family members, from our parents? And you can go down the line. Culture, society, whatever. And my spirit was talking to me and it was saying, you know what, seer, why can't you have your cake and eat it too? Why can't you have, and I'm speaking metaphorically, not specifically personally for me, but I'm speaking for people in general. Why can't you have that type of person that you want? Why can't you have that type of income that you want? Why can't you have that type of house that you want? Is it because we have believed the lies and alibis of other people? Is it because of our life experiences and we have somehow gotten ourselves into a circle of poverty? And when I say poverty, I don't mean just lack of money. I mean lack in general, lack of self-esteem, lack of self-confidence. Because at one time I was the poster child for that. Not anymore, though. Nobody can tell you what you can't get or what you don't deserve. And some of the biggest things that people may say to you that may deter you from getting what you want or discourage you from getting what you want, or you're too old. You better put that to you. You're too old. You can't find another person. You're too old. Don't nobody want you. You're too old. Or here's something that they say to a lot of women. Oh, you have too many children. Don't nobody want you with all them children. You're a single mother. Don't nobody want you. That's one of the, that's one of the things they say too. Or you're too fat. Don't nobody want you. And I think one of the reasons that some wisdom coming through this morning. I can tell. I think one of the reasons that people oftentimes believe these lies that I just mentioned, that I just aforementioned, these lies that have been told to them, I think that people believe those fucking lies because we're not being honest with ourselves. And when I say we're not being honest with ourselves, I'm speaking in terms of what we want and the people that we want. For example, I'm going to be totally honest with you. There are certain men I simply just do not like. There are certain men that I just don't like. I like men with certain aesthetic features. If you go back and look in my video archives, and you see the videos and the pictures I've posted of my friend Christopher Barry, if you look at his features, typically those are the type of features that I am attracted to. But because we live in a world now where you can't say that, because people will say, oh, you're a colorist, or you. No, it's not that I'm a colorist. It's not that I think that those features are superior. It's just that that is what I'm attracted to. I'm attracted to those types of features. And a lot of it is just based upon how men who look like that, because he was fine, Christopher Barry was fine, men who look like that have really treated me the best. When I have given men chances or opportunities who had more, let's just say, stronger Negro features, they turned out to be the most self-hating. They hated other black people. They definitely hated themselves. And ultimately, they hated me. And I'm not saying that the features have anything to do with it. I'm going by the experience. And remember, it's a universal law that we are shaped by our experiences, right? So if we're shaped by our experiences, then that would make sense why those types of men I may have a prejudice towards based upon my experience dealing with them. See, there's always a legend to the legend. You feel what I'm saying? For example, in the movie Candyman, we thought that Candyman was just a crazed, psychotic, murdering, monstrous, demonic ghost killer or unseen killer. But in actuality, Candyman had a story. He had a whole legend. There was a legend behind the legend. And I know I'm getting off track, but you know, I'm the occult view. This will all interconnect. There was a legend behind the legend. He was brutalized. He was murdered because he fell in love with a white woman. And her father found out, and they brutalized him and murdered him like they did a lot of black men during that time and after. And he got her daughter, and he, excuse me, he got the man's daughter pregnant. So they killed him, they tortured him, and they murdered him. That shaped his experience in the afterlife. And in the afterlife, he became something much more sinister, much more deadly. He became something much more dangerous because of his experience. Now, if you didn't know his backstory, you would just think that he was evil. Right? And I know I'm talking about a lot of things, but that's how spirit works. You talk about a multitude of different things, and eventually it all interconnects like a puzzle, even if it doesn't make sense. But Candyman was told he wasn't good enough for that white man's daughter. He was told that, and he was murdered for that reason. Because he was told, and it was believed that he wasn't good enough because he was a black man. And ultimately, what shaped his ultimate reality, which was his afterlife, was based upon that experience. So that's what I'm saying about people, myself included. We are shaped by our experiences sometimes. And I'm only speaking from my own spirit. I'm not really speaking for everybody else. If you get something out of it, you get something out of it. I always like to leave that disclaimer because, you know, motherfuckers think, you know, you're talking about them when you're not. I don't give a fuck about nobody else's, you know, spiritual journey. That's your business. Unless you're somebody that I'm cool with and you get something out of this. But why do we let people tell us we're not good enough? And why do we believe that? Because we're not honest with ourselves. If we were honest with ourselves and said, you know what? The more and more I look at this person, I'm not attracted to this type of person. I'm attracted to this type of person over here more so. Just as an example, it doesn't have to be human attraction, it could be anything. Another issue, another problem is, and I didn't really want to speak on this, but I think I'm going to have to. We have a subservient relationship with the universe. And that is why the universe treats us the way that it does. And that is why people who are in fake positions of power, I'm not talking about no motherfucking government, I ain't talking about that shit. I'm talking about, you know, in general, people who think they are in positions of power, even people here on YouTube who think they're these social influencers and think that they're this and think that they're that, telling people that you got to do this and you got to do that. If we have a subservient relationship, and this ties into everything as well, if we have a subservient relationship with the universe, then we are also going to have a subservient relationship with other people around us. The universe treats you accordingly. The universe treats you based upon your energy, your frequency, and your vibration. And if you have a slave mentality, like a lot of Black people do, then that's exactly how you are going to be treated. And I've come into this information recently by reading this book. It's called Psychological Dominance 101. Somebody recommended it. And it talks about how you can put people under your control. But I don't want to put people under my control. That's stupid. I don't really want to do that. I don't believe in trying to control people. You know, that's like a cult type of thing. And, you know, the more and more I read the book, I understand where the author is coming from. But I want to take it a step further. I want to take it a step further. I look beyond, and this is what makes me a seer, because I look beyond the words and the energies and the vibrations. What the author is really telling you has nothing to do with you controlling other people. What the author is really trying to say on the back end is how you can control the universe. And how you take yourself out of a slave, subservient position with the universe so you can get the things that you want. So you don't have to be at the mercy of false prophets, false prophetesses, fake spiritualists, and fake people in general. You don't have to be at their mercy, because when the universe, when you have a peer-to-peer relationship with the universe, then you can manifest whatever you want. You might have to still get guidance from, real, authentic, spiritualist and people of that nature. You may still have to do that, or spiritual people, or whatever you believe in. You may still have to get guidance. Doesn't mean that you reject guidance. It just means that you don't totally depend on that person or anyone, because you will be setting up a new relationship and foundation with the universe yourself, where you can have a direct relationship with your universe or the universe, where you can materialize and manifest whatever you want. And especially as Black people, we are supposed to have command over the motherfucking universe, especially Black women. And men too, but especially Black women. There should not be any Black woman begging or being subservient to anyone for anything. Especially when you, by nature and by divinity, have a direct relationship with the universe. Men, we have to build ourselves up a little bit more to get that type of connection. And Black men nowadays, I don't know, you niggas are just fucking lost, a lot of you. Not all of you, but a lot of you, you're just fucking lost. I'm sorry. It's just that's me being honest. Remember, be honest. Be honest. Because it can't all be about materialistic things. And that is where a lot of Black men go wrong. And some Black women too, but mainly Black men. They make it all about materialistic stuff. You get everything, you create the perfect hell for yourselves. Because while you may get everything you want, you get absolutely nothing at all. Because then you become a slave to that. You get what you want physically, but you become a slave to that. Because see, what I want from the universe and what I command really and truthfully is more so wisdom and knowledge than anything else. And everything else will follow. Everything else will follow. So as long as we have this, and this is people in general, as long as we have this subservient relationship with the universe, then we're going to always be in a position of servitude with other people. And they will continuously be able to candyman us and tell us we ain't good enough for this and we ain't good enough for that. Or you have to look like this to get that. There are 7 billion people on this planet. 7 billion people on this planet and growing. But we have been bamboozled, as my good friend Miss Marie would say, who's no longer with us. But we've been bamboozled to believe these ideologies and these concepts, that were put forth by people who do not have our best interest at heart. And it can be your family members. It can be your parents. It can be the people that's laying right in the motherfucking bed with you. It can be people living right in your motherfucking house. And I'm not speaking about anybody personally with me. One of the reasons that my situation works, it's because I have command over the universe. And I don't say that in an egotistical way. There's always higher levels and higher hierarchies and more to learn. And it's always good to have respect for those higher levels of energies and spiritual whatever. So this isn't coming from an egotistical place. But what I'm saying is that when you're expanding your consciousness, that should also give you some more control over what you want and what you want to manifest. And one of the reasons that even though there have been some things that have happened that I don't really particularly enjoy, challenges, because we are having a physical experience, I know how to get control over the universe and bend it to my will. That's true alchemy and energy manipulation. Being able to bend things to your will and making things work for you. That's what I'm talking about. But you can't do that when you have a subservient mindset. And that was the real, because see, Black people had command over the universe, especially the Black woman. So when they put the Black woman, when they degraded the Black woman, let me just say it this way, when they degraded the Black woman and pushed her to the side and then put false prophetess and false gods before her, then that is when everything went to hell in a handbasket. Because as I said earlier, the Black woman has a direct lineage to the universe. You better be glad you came out of a Black vagina. You better be grateful you came out of a Black vagina. You better be grateful, because that's where the power is. But the problem is that a lot of Black men have misused that energy. They have. And they've taken that energy and they have given it to others who don't really know what to do with it. Oh, this is what this is what they did with it. They took it and made it into religion and told you that you had to beg and that you had to worship a Christian God. They turned it into a masculine energy. And they told you that you have to beg on your knees and worship a Christian God for whatever you want. And then they gave you the illusion that they were getting what they wanted through these Masonic networks. See, the only reason a lot of them preachers and pastors get what they want, that has nothing to do with divine. Nothing. It has nothing to do with divine intervention or divine blessings. It's because those motherfuckers are up in Masonic groups and they all look out for each other. It's an interconnected network. It's an interconnected network. And they tell other people, oh, you're not good enough to be in our club. You ain't good enough. You ain't good enough. We're going to candyman you. Have you been candyman? Doesn't have to be the physical trauma. We're talking about spiritual trauma, and that doesn't take place in the physical. We're going to candyman you. We're going to keep all of the knowledge and information and wisdom to ourselves that we've collected over the years about you. Like the late, great Eugenia Duncan told me. She said she wanted her shit back. She said she wanted her shit back. The late, great Eugenia Duncan, my spiritual godmother. who was a fucking genius. She was a genius mathematician. But she was candyman. They candymanned her and then tormented her until she took her own life. But this is what they did. So they took the information, the real information, the real knowledge and wisdom, they took it, shared it with others, and they created an interconnected network. I don't know why I can't say that this morning. An interconnected network where they want to have everybody come to them begging for blessings and begging to be a slave. And that is what the foundation of this world has been built upon. And anyone that goes outside of that paradigm, witches, warlocks, and all of and what I just named, witches, warlocks, all of those things embody wisdom. Anyone who does not fall in line with their slave thinking, they will attack you, they will bully you, and they will lock you out so you cannot be a part of that network. They will lock you out of jobs, they will lock you out of opportunities, they will do all of these types of things to you. And that is why people like me and others and the others who are like me, we have to find our own ways because we're the real creative powers. And creativity is not just about singing or painting. Creativity is also can also be about communication because I understand the art of communication and how to use that in order to benefit me. You have to know how to communicate in order to manifest. And that they can't take away from you. They can't take away your gifts that were bestowed upon you. But they try to take away information that may help you, and they give it to other people so they can come up, and then you go to those people, and those people will tell you, you ain't good enough. Some of them are so-called relationship gurus, men and women. You ain't good enough. You too old to find a man. You too old to do this. You too old to do that. You too fat to do this. They don't want you. Haven't y'all heard that all before, black woman? Black women, haven't you heard that before? You've heard that all before, right? See, I'm gonna get a little bit, I'm gonna talk about the Bible. The Bible said that we're not fighting against flesh and blood, that we're fighting against spiritual wickedness in high places and principalities. And they're talking about the spiritual wickedness of people. They're not necessarily talking about spirits. They're talking about the spiritual wickedness of people who are in positions of power. You got to understand what that word really means because so many people want to put things on spirits all the time. So ain't no motherfucking spirits. Those are people who are in high positions in these fucking Masonic groups, or so they think they're in high positions, so they think. They just have access to information that they withhold and they lock people out. And then they give you people like Kevin Samuels. They give you people like, who else? Other people that follow that type of energy. who tell people they ain't good enough. And then you notice these people are manifesting and making money off of the black woman's energy. Because they have candymanned you, black woman. They've candymanned me too. They've candymanned black men too. You have to have your own relationship with the universe. You have to have your own relationship with the universe. And it should not be based upon slave and master. But that's the only thing that black people know on a subconscious level is a slave-master relationship. And that is why we don't manifest the things that we want because we don't believe that we deserve it. We believe that we have to beg and squalor and, crawl on the ground like a snake. Like the curse that God put on the serpent in the Garden of Eden when that serpent deceived Eve into tricking the man into eating the fruit off of the tree of knowledge. But see, the reason that that God did not want Eve to eat off of the tree of knowledge was because her eyes would be opened and she would be wise like God's. Because that particular God was like the Masons and these other interconnected groups that hold all the knowledge and the wisdom. Eve was Candyman, and so was Adam. And that's what these groups do. They hold the information and knowledge. They don't want people to have it. So they punish those who seek it. They try to anyway. See, the snake was Eve's friend. The snake was Eve's friend. That was the Kundalini energy, in case people didn't know. That was rising up in her and Adam. And I know it's all allegorical or metaphorical, whatever you want to classify it as, but I'm bringing it to you in a human form to give you an understanding. That wasn't no motherfucking God in the Garden of Eden. That was a motherfucking Mason or another secret society group at that time, part of an ancient order to suppress the public from gaining spiritual wisdom and knowledge. And Eve was a victim of that. She was a victim. She wanted knowledge, and they didn't want. It wasn't just one so-called God, it was multiple. And they didn't want Eve to have that knowledge. They didn't want Adam to have that knowledge. And the reason that the snake went to the woman is because the snake knew the woman's hierarchy in the spiritual world. Because the woman is supposed to lead spiritually. No matter what these misogynistic men may think, it is what the fuck it is. Men cannot compare to women magically. Those are facts. Most of us can't. I'm not referring to myself. I'm not Candyman in myself. They didn't want Eve to have that knowledge. So they candymanned her and they put a curse on her and said that women destroyed the world. They candymanned Eve. They literally castrated her the same way they did Candyman. And they blamed her for the downfall of humankind. And told her she wasn't good enough. You have your own relationship with the universe. You can have your cake and eat it too if you want. There's nothing that says you can't have your cake and eat it too. There's nothing that says that you can't have the things that you want. You just don't allow the things that you want to become your master. You're supposed to master even that. It's time for people to stop listening to these lower vibrating people telling you have to do this and you have to do that. No, you don't. You have to change your mindset because the universe is all. What is it saying? The mind is all and the universe is mental. And that's going back to that book for a moment, Psychological Dominance 101. That's really the whole point of that book. It's all about the mind and your relationship with the universe, which is your mind. And as long as you have a subservient relationship with the universe, you will always be up under somebody else's domination. You will always be up under someone else's control as long as the universe is controlling you and you're not controlling it. Anyway, that's all I really wanted to come through and say. You can like it, you can love it, you can hate it. Quite frankly, I don't give a fuck. I said it, and I'm not taking it back because in my universe, I do what the fuck I want to do. And what I say is my will. Thank you.